Hello everyone, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to discover how to launch and play Zooba on your PC. Here you are able to watch it on screen. It will be possible to efficiently download and install Zooba and play your game on our Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. Then it's time to have fun, let's go buddies. First of all folks, to start we need to launch our main internet browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, because there's a link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our Usitility website, where we have a thorough summary on just how to download and install Zooba on computer. We scroll down a bit and click the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we get to the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Zooba on PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of advantages of preferring the emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Then, we will start downloading the Zooba by simply clicking on this button Download Zooba on PC that you can see here in green color. We then click on it, and the download action takes no time at all. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the system. We answered yes. I reduce the browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installer is very simple. It is made up of two choices: install and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path actually does. We merely simply click on it. And now we see that we display here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be placed. If we are planning to vary this directory, we are required to click on the Browse button, and we pick another folder and install the emulator where we wish. I prefer to leave it where it is. Then, I click on Back. So I simply click on Install. Right now, before starting setting up that emulator, it is also possible that it's going to offer us several software packages to install on our PC. Because I do not wish to have any of these software, I only press several times on the reject option. Voila, the installation commences and it's going to carry on along with the download of all these MB that are visible on the screen. Once you download it, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed can be faster or at a lower speed, depending on your type of access to the web and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator hosting servers. Now they're working superbly fast. The download is done, and instantly it continues with the setup part. The setup needs more or less time primarily based on the power of your PC. The more powerful it really is, the faster the installation time and vice versa. If we join the download and software setup phase, it normally takes quite a long time, so show patience. It has now completely finished on my side. At this moment, the emulator has been started on autopilot. As you can observe, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up, then when it comes to the ending, the emulator will be started for the first time. The fact is the emulator has already been started, here for the first time. Plus LD Store is automatically started, that is a sort of Google Play. That isn't the smartest option to install the video game, and I do not recommend it, for the reason that on occasion the LD Store installs an outdated version of the video game. I am about to show you the right way to install the Android game making use of the Google Play. I recommend you to do it this way. The very first thing we must begin doing is to head to the computer's desktop by simply clicking on this software icon that I'm pointing out in green color. Before we carry on, as you can discover, it created two software icons there on the computer desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player app icon is the only one we're interested in. Anytime we choose to launch Zooba on our PC, we double mouse click on this app icon and run the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon is not related to multiplayer or even nearly anything such as that. The truth is, it is an software icon that we will probably never utilize. Why don't we do the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to visit the Google Play Store. To do that we will browse there to System Apps, we click on. And we'll click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is launched. In this case we have got to log on. At this time when we're right here, we have to conduct this next phase which is absolutely mandatory. So we click on Sign In. At this moment it says checking info. It might occasionally get blocked in checking info. Additionally, it fails to proceed. If that's the case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it will surely most probably be corrected. At this moment we are going to type our username and password. The email address really needs to be a Gmail email and its associated password. For example, you can use the same email address you're using right now in your YouTube account. Thus I will enter my details and I will go back as soon as I have accomplished it. That's all, data typed. Below is Google welcoming us and supplying us their twos. We would accept them all by clicking on, I agree. Following, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might let it selected and this will make a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize this option if you prefer. We click accept. From now Google Play is launched by default and immediately. Whenever the Google Play just isn't presented instantly and you do not know how to start it manually, I assist you how to get it done. First thing is to navigate to the emulator desktop by clicking on this icon designated in green color. At present we go to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Fine. We're right inside of Google Play. What we are going to perform right now is browse here to search for apps and games. So we are going to research Zooba. Furthermore, there we get it, we should pick the first result. Right here we have the Android game. How about we simply click right here on the install choice that I am just highlighting now in green color. Therefore it will start the software setup. Right now it would download and install the game app. It might take a bit of time or it could be very fast. This all is dependent upon on our internet connection. It's by then finished setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting the following option that I'm showing in green, if you want to start Zooba for the first time. We're by now on the emulator desktop, and then we are preparing to click the fresh Zooba icon which was created. This game is started for the first time. Now there we end up with it, I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the sound level of this emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we don't depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we should switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is the very first one. We simply click on this particular app icon which I'm pointing out in green color. Then the screen is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. Assuming that we desire to launch the app using all the screen, we mouse click on that application icon. And then we would without a doubt be experiencing the game app in 100% screen function. To escape the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we just end up being in regular display setting. At this moment I am going to clarify you the keys mapping that is definitely surprisingly helpful. This step we will be able to use the video game a lot more easily. The first point is to press this keyboard icon. And here you will be able to complete the appropriate configuration settings. I can let the normal configuration, though if you desire to change it, you can easily do so without any problem. I just take this opportunity to say that in certain cases, when commencing the Android game a dark screen comes out, if this is like that and you see the black screen and the emulator doesn't initiate, I comment a feasible alternative. We should go here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator options, in the advanced selection we have got a range of resolutions. The following is the image resolution that we have previously selected by default and we must select any of these additional image resolutions, for example that one here. We pick it and click on save. It may tell us to reboot that emulator and once rebooted, most probably the emulator will start and the black display will vanish entirely. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our own language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is presented in the improper language, for example, in Mandarin. And therefore to set it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here throughout various other options, we click that language drop down. We will go for the language we want, German, Chinese, etc. Once the language is selected, we could save, the emulator would restart, along with the game application, the next time we use it, would of course be in the chosen language. At present, there is another point that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google saying that a different device has been connected to our Google account. It is going to check with us if we are the ones who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we may not worry, considering the fact that emulator is emulating in Google Android tablet or smartphone. In order to see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. And so we go here to the model selection. And there we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my video tutorial. I anticipate you appreciated it, especially that everyone found it interesting. If so, give it a good like, subscribe, and any comments, concerns or ideas, leave them in the comment area below. You could possibly also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams ever so often, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of these training videos that happens to be showing up on the screen and see you in the following videos. Bye.